नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लाइफ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन विद भगवद गीता। टुडे सेशन विल बी ऑन चैप्टर 2, श्लोक 14 टू 16। विल स्टार्ट विद श्लोक नंबर 14। मात्रा स्पर्शास्तु कौन्तेय शीतोष्ण सुख दुख दाः आगमापायिनो नित्याः तांति तिक्षस्व भारत। As we have seen, the Lord Krishna has started and taking the Arjuna towards the Samkhya Yoga. Slowly, the philosophy is going more and more deeper, and we will go step by step and will unravel all the layers which are there. So here he talks about matra sparshastu. It means contact of senses with the objects. We have 5 sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. These are the 5 sense organs, and our mind operates through all these 5 sense organs. They are the food for the mind. How? If I see, my eyes are watching here and there, through which the things I am perceiving through my eyes. Eyes are the medium, is a sense organ, but mind, information is giving the mind through my eyes. That's some, wow, what beautiful nature. It's seen from the eyes. So point is, as the here Bhagavan says, matra sparshastu, mind to function through these 5 sense organs. Next he says, Kaunteya shitoshna sukha dukkhadaha. The pairs of opposite now starts over here. Shita, ushna, cold and hot. Sukha, dukkha, happiness and pleasure. What you are trying to say, every coin has two sides, which are inseparable. There is happiness after misery. There is a cold, there is a hot. In the morning you feel very hot, in the afternoon 12 o'clock, when you go in the evening 5, 6, it's cold. What he next says, the sense organs perceive the thing through these opposite pairs. Either by operation of any of these sense organs, either give us pleasure or it will give us pain. What a beautiful nature! It's a pleasure. Ah, that place is very dirty. Pain. Look at the tongue, what a beautiful gulab jam, very tasty. What a bitter the karela. What a beautiful music it is, it's very pleasant. How loud the music is, very much pain. All of us sense of, what a beautiful smell it is. What? It's very, when you go near the garbage area, it's very, I could not stand with it. So sense organs, either, the point is that sense organs either give us pleasure or they give us pain. Either they give us happiness or they give us sadness. That is the nature of the sense organs where it is entangled with your mind. Next, what Bhagavan says, agama painaha, means it has beginning and it has end also, my friend. This is now here the point starts. Change is permanent is mentioned over here. Agama painaha, it has beginning, it has end. For example, many of us have seen, when we are passing through the road, we feel very good smell of vada pav is there. bhaji pav is going on, it's very hot, bhajis are, someone is making a bhajis and the mind starts tangling, no, it's very nice, I should test it. That thing comes for sudden duration, but a mind says, no, I'm in a hurry, I have to reach on time. If I spend my time for 5 minutes for eating, I'll be late and my boss will scold me. So we move ahead. Here, the mind has, intellect has given mind instruction, you are something is otherwise, you'll have a problem. But if the mind is engaged with this test, so it has beginning and it has end. If it depends on mind, how much long it want to stay in that duration. For example, we are passing through the road, vada pav wala is there, the very beautiful smell is coming. But if we not allow mind has engaged us because nose has given a signal to the mind, wow, we should test it. Now what we say is, no, I don't want, I am going forward. The mind has engaged only that time. So everything which we perceive has beginning, it has end. It's same is about everything. It's only that I can just one example, looking at the things, listening the things, everything has beginning, everything has an end. Anger, now we'll come back, this is at the same certain level. A body has beginning, body has end. When I was kid, my skin is not like that. I'm younger, my skin hair is like this. After some time, when I age start, my skin will start dull, my hair will start becoming white and like that. So everything has beginning, everything has end. Let's come back to mind. Mind is to, for today's sake, we'll understand mind is a conglomeration of thoughts. Thoughts come, thoughts go away. It has certain duration. It has beginning, it has end. Then, same applies to our emotions. We have anger. We get anger with particular person and in that anger we may react and some problem may happen. For example, it's very common example which we see, that child is there, mother scolds the child that you have made a mistake, very some fight has happened. What child? I will not eat food. Whose harm it is? Child's. Anger has come. Anger has played the role. He says, no, you should not eat the mom. Your mom has scolded you. You should not eat the food. Anger has gone. Then hunger will come. Let's see now what happens. But anger is the more powerful. It has given ego a challenge of the child that don't eat. Who's lost in this? The child. If anger would have come, if he just stayed passive, that the example which we have seen while we are passing through the road and vada pav wala said, no, go away. This thing wouldn't have happened. So, agama paina, everything, every emotion, happiness, sadness, whatever problems are coming into our life, have beginning, have end. Also, nothing is permanent in your life. Tanatitikshastra bharataha, endure it, my dear. This is what Krishna says. Here he explains that constant, the change is constant. Every, why change is constant? Because everything is perceived by all the sense organs, have beginning, have end. So, don't enter, don't react on the things which have natural beginning and natural end. It will die automatically. Don't you put in yourself the way child has done it. So this is very beautiful. This loka has said, matra svashastra kaunteya, contact of senses with the object. Shitoshna sukha dukkha daha. means what? This when a mind engaged with the senses, it gives only two reactions, either positive, either negative, the pairs of opposite. Then what we should do, that is explained in the next stanza. If the pairs of opposite comes, the mind has perceived the senses, now what to do?
Yam yam hi na vyathayantyete purusham purusharshabah sama dukkha sukham dhiram somrutatvaya kalpate.
So here he says, the firm man remain passing on these pairs of opposites. He does not react. He just be a neutral person. That's, and those who remains a neutral person, he attains immortality. It's another word has been introduced by the Bhagavan over here. Let us understand this thing. The pairs of opposite comes, we should not react. How? If you look at example of this, you know what, Nilesh? I have seen, I've heard that to whomever you talk, they always talk negative about. This is Dinesh, you know, he's very angry person, he's very fool and like that. You know what? So closer friends are speaking like that. Who has perceived? My ears. Now this instruction has went to my mind. Oh, like that. My best friend is talking such negative things about me. How he dare? Anger has come. Now what I will do? Either I will call him and use my bad words, or physical things may happen, violence may happen if the extreme anger is there, or I'll stop talking to him. This is how mind will operate. This will give me either pleasure, it will give me pain. But a wise man, firm man, don't react over it. In this situation, what the wise man will do? Okay, my friend has talked about me. No. It's a good thing, no? He's talking about me. It means my name is there in his mind. He hasn't forgotten me. And who is telling me this thing? The person to whom I have met just 2 days back. I know my friend since the last 5 to 6 years, and I have fully faith he will not speak with me about me like that. So why to react? Even why to ask the question to my friend? Because I have full faith on him. But this is how it happens. A wiser man reacts. He's totally neutral. There is one wonderful story was there. The king was going for hunting, and one hunter has the rock had. There is one guy was there. He wanted to eat a mango. He was throwing a stone at the mango and tried to bring it down. By mistakenly, that rock, that stone, has hit the king, and king has slightly injured. Then he called the person. He said, "Ki, please excuse me. It's not. It's unknowingly it happened to me. And I wanted a mango. That's why I was trying my best to hit the mango tree to get it down." The king has said his minister, "Give him gold." What? He has hitting you the stone. Stone has said to the king and. Instead of giving him punishment, you are giving him gold. But minister has to follow what king has to do. So he has, he's like, okay, he has given gold to the person. And the minister asks the king, "King, why? Because he has injured you and you are giving him gold. I do not understand. We should punish him because you are our king and he has knowing that doesn't matter." King said, his goal was what? To get a mango. For what? To fulfill him. His fulfill his food. He was hitting a tree to get the mango. To get the mango. He has hit it, now me. I should give much better than the mango. He was trying to, because he was trying for the mango. He was hitting the mango tree to get the mango. Now he has hit me. I am much bigger than that tree. So I should do something. If you look at a tree, if you look at the nature elements, mountain, we are being unnecessarily destroying the environment, but environment is not reacting. Let him do it, whatever he wants. We are plucking the flowers directly from the garden. It doesn't say garden, now you are plucking out of my tree, I will not give my smell. It doesn't happen. It always gives its smell. Because they know, they don't get affected whether you give me pleasure or you give me pain. I will do only my duty for which I have been taken a birth. So this is, should be the wise man's nature. We should not engage in the pairs of opposite. Instead, we should be neutral and passive and just be observe what is happening in and around. That is what he is saying. Sama dukkha sukham dhiram. So amritatva, immortality. Mortality is a death that's about which we everyone have a fear of death. That's very beautifully he has amritatvaya, immortality. The wiser person, what is the scope? If we want to become immortal, if we want to attain samadhi, if we want self-realization, if we want to attain the moksha, or if we want to cross over, if we want to cross over the cycle of birth and death, the first step we should do that. Sama dukkha sukham dhiram. Pairs of opposite are there. Don't engage any of the pair of opposite. Don't be too much happy in happy moment. Don't be too much sad in sad. You just be neutral and passive. Like a tree. Like a flower. You just do your duty and that's it. Then only you attain the immortality. If you could not able to balance yourself in the pairs of opposites, you don't think about to attain immortality. You forget about it. If you want to become immortal, we have to cross over it. We have to balance in our pairs of opposites. We have to be stable. That's what it is trying to say. The next further says, why? What is the reason for that?
Nasato vidyate bhavah, na bhavo vidyate satah, ubhayorapi drushtantah, tu anayo tattva darshivihi.
The unreal has no being, and there is no being of the real. Little bit confusing, very clear. It says unreal has no value, real is always present. What is unreal and what is real, we'll understand that first. In Vedas very nicely saying, the thing which was not in the past, which will not be in the future, is unreal. I'll repeat it. Thing which was not in the past and will not be in the future, thing which was not in the past, thing which will not be in the future, is unreal. Human body, and because we are just for 60, 70, 100 years, after that his body has nothing. It is unreal. The nature elements, the mountains, the rivers, Saraswati river is not there now. Every river changes its discourses. It means this is also unreal. Let's come back to a mind, which is a conglomeration of thoughts. Our thoughts are continuously changing. For example, in a childhood I wanted to become an engineer, but when I am college, engineering is very boring, I should enter some commerce site or this. Mind is changing. Whichever is changing, is unreal. The mind is also unreal. Intellect. When we are young, right now I am grown up, but if you ask me what happened in history, what was the birth date of Shivaji? The study the books which you are studying, the first standard, you don't know. Intellect is also changing. It is not constant. If it is constant, we would have remembered everything. So, this is also unreal. Body is unreal. Mind is unreal. Intellect also unreal. So, what is left? What is left? Everyone has seen the river. River has water, has stones and pebbles and sand. A lot of things are there. But why these all things are flowing is because some empty space was available. Because of that, the river is flowing. That empty vessel, that something is there which is binding the river, which is binding the stone, which is binding the pebbles, that is real. There is something which is binding my body, which is binding my mind, intellect together, because of whom I am able to experience all these things, is real. That is the inner self. Left, everything is unreal. That is what you are trying to say. Na sato vidyate bhava, na bhavo vidyate satana. Ubhayorapi drishtanta, pairs of opposites. This is unreal. Anger, unreal. Why to get angry against a person? He has used lot of bad words about me, my family and everything. I will never excuse him. Who are you to excuse him? You yourself is unreal, my friend. When you are used to play a toys, by mistakenly toys got broken up, it's okay. We buy another toy. We don't scold that person. Why you have? No, it has made of sand and the plastic or so, whatever material, it has tendency to broken. Similar manner, why to get angry against a person for a lifetime? He is my enemy for lifetime. Why? You are unreal, he is unreal, everything is unreal. Why to worry? How anger has come? Why to anger? And who are you to anger on? He has talked bad words about you. Who are you? Has he talked used bad words about your body? He might. People are used to use racism in this. All this thing you have experienced. People talk about your skin color and everything. But is that skin is yours? Things on which we have ownership, on that things only we have right. Otherwise we don't have right. If the car hits my car, some other car is hitting my car, they will again drop my car and I ask them a question. If some second car is going on and that hit the third car, why should I go? We don't go into that because there is no ownership. In this body, is it your ownership only body? No. Because this body is itself changing. You are just experiencing the things through all this body. So why do you get angry? Why do we create enemies? Nobody's enemy. Everyone is your friend. Have compassion to all. Then why do you kill Kauravas? Why do you kill Kauravas? If they are my friends. Why should I kill my Dronacharya? Why should I kill Bhima? Vishnu. Vishnu arises. Here it clarifies. Body is changing, mind is changing, intellect is changing. Bhishma, Dronacharya, as we discussed earlier session also, mentally, intellectually, they are dead. Kauravas, Duryodhana are dead, but mentally, intellectually, it's only the body you are keeping away. That's it. When the pot of glass or the flower pot is broken in our house, what we do? We keep it as it is, or we collect it and put it in a dustbin. Is it right? Have we done anything? In a similar manner, Bhishma, Dronacharya, others have mentally, intellectually have died. There is nothing left for them to do in this life. They have completely broken, like a flower pot. About we could not collect this together and again create a flower pot. So let it to be buried in the dustbin. After reprocessing, it will be utilized. That we'll see how it is. So don't think that you are killing. You are not killing anybody. Who are you to kill anybody? It's through you it's happening. You are just the broken particles. You are bringing it together and using it some other places so that it will recycle and it will become good product again. So nasato vidyate bhavah na bhavo vidyate sata ubhayor vivishtanta tu anayoho tatva darshibhi. By the knowers of understand this reality, real, unreal, don't entangle yourself into this unreal world. Be more and more closer to the real world. That is what Gita is trying to say. So today's our lesson, if we summarize our today's lesson, we started with 14th shloka. We talked about agma paina, sense organs, mind works when sense organs, the foods of our mind. If there is some problem in the food, then toxins come enter into our mind. So don't allow mind to engage all the time with the sense organs. How not to organ? Because all the sense organ things perceive either gives us happiness, either gives us sadness. So that is agama, and they are agama paina. They are beginning. Everything in the world has beginning and an end. With the human being, animals, the nature, the mountains, and everything has beginning, everything has an end. Then what the thing on which have beginning and end are called unreal. Things which doesn't have any beginning, doesn't have any end is real. So focus on that real only. And how to understand reality? You have to be neutral. Ubhayorapi drishtantah. You have to be neutral. Don't entangle into these pairs of opposite. If you engage yourself into these pairs of opposite, you won't get anything. If you want to go beyond of this, then you will attain the immortality, that is amritatva. So friends, we'll see in the next week. We'll go further, 17 to 20, and we'll go more deeper of this philosophy now. So do read, do watch this. If you don't understood anything, repeat again, but make yourself clear and